Do you want to know how to use the KDP Print cover template? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the cover template for KDP Print using GIMP. Stay tuned. Welcome to Self Publishing with Dale, where you'll learn how to publish books that sell and build an unstoppable brand. Today, we're going to discuss how to use the cover template for KDP Print books. But first, there's a few items that you're going to need, and it's going to be your ebook cover, GIMP, also known as GNU Image Manipulation Program, your book description, and this is an optional thing, get your biography ready for the book. Let's get right to it. All right, I've already downloaded GIMP. I'm just gonna go ahead and open it up with double clicking it. All right, now that we've got GIMP open, I wanna go ahead and we're just gonna do just a very simple Google search, and it's gonna be KDP Print Cover Template. And we're gonna go right onto kdp.amazon.com. Okay, so I know right away that my trim size is 6x9. I'm gonna select an option. We're gonna choose 6x9. I have 232 pages in my book. Now, based on paper color, it's either white, cream, or color. It's not a full color book. I actually selected white when I printed this out. This is gonna vary based on the project that you're going with. We're just gonna go ahead and download cover template. Let's go ahead and we're going to unzip this file. I'm going to extract all. I'm just going to keep it right in the downloads folder. Double click and open that. I just need the PNG file. So here's what we're going to do is we're going to minimize all the other windows. Then we're going to just drag and drop that over onto the surface. Keep. Same as before. We're just going to drag and drop it onto the surface. We're going to keep. All right, so we're going to take the alignment tool. This is perfectly fit for 9 inches high. I'm going to select the alignment tool. We're going to point it right at the cover. Let's go over into the tool options. We're going to move it all the way over to the right. Now, in the event that when you dragged and dropped it into place, it was out of position, we're just going to go ahead and center it with the cover, and then we'll right align it. Now, here's the little tricky part. We're just going to grab the move tool. We're going to left click, just left click once on the cover. We don't want to move it at all. And with your arrow key, we're just going to press over to the left until we get right to that dotted line at the spine. Now, the next thing we're going to want to do is I'm going to color pick. We're going to grab the color picker tool. I'm going to come over to the cover again, and I'm going to grab one of these dark ones because I want to make sure we blend it really nicely. So we've selected that. It's already picked that black color there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep this template here and I'm going to duplicate that. We're going to select the duplicate layer. I'm just going to shut that layer, the bottom layer off. Now for this top one, what we're going to do is since we have the foreground color with that color pick tool, okay, we're going to just going to go ahead and press Control, comma. We're going to shut this off just for right now because we're going to need to see where the bleed lines are at. Our next step, let's see about putting all the information on the back cover. So now that you got your book description, we're just going to go ahead and I'm just going to click it right into there. I like Baybos New. It's probably one of my favorite ones. It matches the fonts there. So the very first thing is let's get that headline, the hook, Control C. Okay, and we're going to hit Control V. Now, don't worry about formatting it just now. We're going to come back to that in just a moment. We're going to create another box. Now let's drop that bio in there. Now the bio is not mandatory. And if you find that you're hard pressed for room on your back cover, you could probably go without it. But I think it's a nice touch. And especially if you're the type of person that goes to networking meetings, you can hand that out. And that bio being on the back cover, it makes it easy for people to kind of go, oh, okay, this guy's pretty important. I'm going to go ahead and in order to change out the font, what we can do is the very first thing we want to do is I want to select our hook. We're going to come up to tool options. I want to center that. And then we're going to make that just a little bit bigger. So you see at the very top of this right there, we're going to go ahead and just kind of make it big. Right? In the event that we want the box to kind of stick with the text itself, we're going to hit dynamic. Now I won't use that for the larger portion of the description. Again, we're going to go ahead and select the next box, select all, Control A. Right, I need something a little bit more subtle, probably something a little closer to like sans serif. Now, in order to kind of check this out, what we'll do is from time to time, we could probably turn on our background, but you'll notice that since it's a black background, it's not going to quite work out in our favor. All right, here we go. Let's do this. I'm going to grab the shape tool, click and drag over the area within the bleeds. That way I know where I want to be. We're going to select the layer there. We're going to hit transparent, hit OK. Awesome. Now, let's just go ahead and fill it with white. Nothing spectacular here. This is just to kind of help us out. We're going to hit Control, period. Now, you'll notice some of the text is down here. And we're going to just drag this open just a little bit more. I want to make sure that it is lined up with that bleed. There we go. Awesome, because we don't run it right on top of the bleed, because that means that it's in danger of going either on the spine or being cut. So we don't want to bother with that. I keep a little bit of wiggle room. All right, same thing. Let's go ahead and we're going to select all. And let's just keep it right in theme with everything else. Sans serif. Okay, right away you can notice that we've got probably too much things going on here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this and I'm going to kick down the size just a bit. Hit 35, enter. Not bad. I'm very happy with this. In the same instance, this kind of looks a little bit out of place. So here's what I'm going to do is I'm going to just italicize this. Yeah, there we go. And since this is all italicized, that's the title, we're going to go ahead and bold that title. Let's just drag this box, kind of like the one we did above. Spread it out a little bit. So it looks like we have just a little bit of a space. And, you know, from a graphic design standpoint, I'm sure people are probably flipping out like, oh my gosh, that's way, way too big, way too small compared to the other one. So all we're going to do is we're just going to try to stretch this out. Oops. Undo. Now let's go ahead and select our closing line here. I'm going to do the same thing like I did with the hook. I'm going to make it dynamic. And we're going to go ahead and let's make it about the same size, 106. Okay, we're going to highlight the whole thing. 106, enter. Okay, that's a little bit too big for my liking. So we're probably just going to just squeeze it right on down. All right, so now all we got to do is we're just going to just scoot this on up. I want to get the bio kind of formatted, so let's kill this layer here. I want to see where that barcode's at. Again, I'm going to go ahead and select all this, and we're going to go sans serif so we can match the other font. Look at that. That works almost perfectly. And let's go ahead and let's do it the same size as the other one. It should be 48. Okay, awesome. And I'm going to put a little bit of emphasis on the author name. I'm going to go a little bigger. I want to take up a good amount of real estate right about there. I'm going to scoot it over. There we go. If we just turn this on, we'll see like the layout looks all right. I'm going to adjust a few things. So we're just going to get the move tool. Okay, now that we have everything laid out, the real challenge is going to be making it look good. We're going to get the color picker tool. Let's go back to that front cover, and I'm just going to pick aqua blue color. There we go. And we're going to switch this. I'm going to go ahead and we're just going to grab just a little bit of that lighter aqua blue. We're going to grab the headline, and let's make it that aqua blue color. So we're going to just pick that again here. Boom. Okay. Awesome. Looks good. Let's go ahead and we're going to do the rest of this in white for right now. It's all going to disappear real briefly, but then we'll have it pop back up. And let's just for the fun of it, we're going to grab this line. We're going to right click on it. Alpha to selection. Let's grab the gradient tool. And now where we drag it, it's going to start with the foreground color and then it'll go into the background color. So watch this. We're going to just click and drag this on up. Okay, Control Shift A. Ah, that's much better. Much, much, much better. I'm going to select just this area. Let's make it white. And then I'm going to select my name. And let's make it that dominant color there. Okay, so if we shut this off and we turn this on, I'm going to select that. We're going to hit the minus key to move out. See how clean that looks? It's not too bad. I feel like we can probably frame out before the content and then possibly after the content. So let's do this. We're going to grab the pencil tool. We're going to go into Tool Options. Why don't we choose the line instead so we can keep it nice and uniform. I'm going to zoom in. Let's hit a Transparency. Okay, so this is going to be our line layer. Okay, here we go. We're just going to kind of hit that, click, Shift. Great. Let's hit the Fuzzy Wand tool. We're going to select that line. I'm going to hit Control-C to copy, Control-V to paste. And now we're going to probably have to zoom in just a little bit. Okay, let's zoom out. Let's do another paste. Just going to move this into place. Looks pretty good. And why don't we do just one more, just for the fun of it. Anchor. Good. I'm going to turn off that black background just to make sure that I'm good with the barcode yet. So here's what we're going to do is let's select the bio layer. I'm going to alpha the selection so I can see where my text is at. And I'm just going to move this down in position here just a little bit. I'm making sure that I'm not covering up the barcode because that's a big no-no. Control-Shift-A will deselect it. Let's turn that background layer on. The very next and very last thing we need to do is get a spine. Now, bear in mind that in order to get a spine, you have to have 100 pages or more. That roughly works out to, and I believe Julie Broad of Book Launchers put it this way, a 30,000 word book is perfect to actually have a spine. Let's just shut off that layer. It looks like our hook is probably perfect for fitting on the spine. So here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna select that hook. Keep in mind, you can always just do a new text box, but I'm gonna make this easy on myself because then I can just duplicate. And let's bring it forward a few layers. So here's, we're gonna kinda come up here. So let's select all of this here, and I'm gonna start to type in. We're going to go up into Layer, Transform, and I wanna flip this clockwise. So that way it goes right on the spine. Okay, next thing, let's take the Alignment tool. We're gonna select that, and let's just go ahead and center it. See that? All right, so now let's turn it back on. Let's see how this looks. All right, last but not least, let's see about exporting this so that way we can upload it over onto KDP Print. What we're gonna do is flatten out all of your visible layers. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna right-click the very top, Merge Visible Layers. We're gonna merge. Now let's hit Control, Shift, and the letter E. And we'll put our title. And we need to save this as a PDF. Select the file and location that you wish to put it on. Here we go. We're going to hit Export. Let's see how this looks. Not bad. I'm very happy with this. But what exactly can you expect when it comes to the KDP Print quality of books? Good news, if you check out this video that is up in the top right corner here, it's going to show you an unboxing of the KDP Print book. I'll see you in the next video.
We send it in that bubble wrap packaging, which leads me to what we can expect from shipping and handling. I am not too happy when it comes to sending...